flight. It's something man has chased from the dawn of time. To be like a bird, the feeling of pure freedom. All for the small price of an exorbitant sum of money. Here's the thing. Helicopters are amazing. They're wonderful machines, but they have one big problem. They are so, so expensive. And that's not fun. Manufacturing and production has been around for a fairly long time, but it doesn't mean that it's got any cheaper. In fact, due to the amount of companies that are outsourcing parts, the cost and time for builds is increasing. But it hasn't always been like this. Back in 1913, the Ford Motor Group decided that they were going to open the Cambridge Assembly, which was a factory in Massachusetts. Now, something that's really, really special about this factory, and that was that it was the world's first vertically integrated production line. This means that they made everything in-house. This was a huge benefit to them because it meant that they could drive down costs, have time management, along with quality control. Now, this was really, really important to them, and it did help them grow as a business. But for some reason, Ford did end up dropping this method of production. But that wasn't to be the end of vertical integration. Now, the company that picked up vertical integration on a large scale again was Tesla. We all know Tesla and have seen the success of them, and it's been so successful that Ford has just announced that they are reverting back to vertical integration so that they can challenge Tesla in the EV market. It'll be very interesting to see where that goes, but it just shows that vertical integration has so many benefits, which is why Hill is using it.
So the basic idea of vertical integration is really simple. You buy raw material in through one door, you add the absolute maximum value that you can within your own business, cutting out all of the middlemen, and then you send your product out the front door, having created the maximum margin for yourself and delivered the product at the best price that you possibly can. Now, in aviation, when we're talking about maybe making 500 units a year, you find yourself in a position where you're never important to any of these suppliers, so you can't command the same terms, and you just can't get anywhere near an automotive price point without that level of commercial leverage. And so, quite counterintuitively, very quickly, it becomes much cheaper to vertically integrate and to just take responsibility for all of the manufacturing yourself. And that's essentially what we've done here.
What I have in my hands here is an example of what vertical integration can look like for Hill. This is a blank piece of raw material, and this is what an outcome of this blank raw material can look like. Now, this enables us to manage timescales and costs. In fact, with vertical integration being implemented into the company, we can save between 20 to 50% on some parts and even more on some niche pieces that need to be made. This is really powerful and can have a lot of effect on the overall cost of producing the HX50.
The moment you can keep your production infrastructure fully occupied all of the time, you can produce parts for basically the same price that the big manufacturers can, but now, because you're making it yourself, you're not paying all of those extra margins. And so vertical integration is a really, really powerful way of bringing back cost control, bringing back quality control, bringing back schedule control at every level in the manufacturing process, and it touches everything that we do.
Now, don't for a moment think that this is a walk in the park or easy peasy. You know, vertical integration takes a lot of work and time and thinking. From investing not only in the machines and the production lines, but into the people that are going to be manning those production lines, all the way down to design and into tooling. All of this costs money, time, and a lot of ingenuity to get right. But when it is completed, it has huge benefits, which is why Hill is doing vertical integration.
The moment you're responsible for making each of these components and you have to develop the production processes for each of these components that go into the aircraft, that then means that that capability, that insight resides within the company, and that finds its way into everything that you do. So vertical integration doesn't just touch what you're doing when you're in production, it has a massive impact on how you design the aircraft and how the aircraft, the engine and its systems are designed with respect to how you want to manufacture them. You get a much more holistic view of what it is you're doing, and you end up designing a much better industrialized aircraft, something that's designed to be manufactured using modern techniques, taking full advantage of all of the technology that exists today that didn't in decades gone by.
But there's a deeper meaning to all of this. It's for our customers. We want to give our customers the best price possible along with the most luxury comfort that is possible. And this is the whole ethos of what we are delivering here at Hill. An affordable, comfortable and luxurious helicopter that can be implemented into your everyday life. As you can see, vertical integration is amazing and it is paving the way to bring the HX50 to market. It will change the aerospace industry because it can drive down that price point that has been an all-time high for all too long. And that was the point of this all, to show what vertical integration can truly do. If you'd like to stay around for more of the journey of the HX50, please hit that subscribe button. There's going to be more content coming very soon, and we are so excited to share the journey of building the first HX50.